Happy New Year from NBC.
Just watch us now.
Robert, who are these people?
Spies.
He has disappeared and frightened for him.
I'm not in that business anymore.
I hope you know what you're doing. Whoa!
I'm a common thief.
What the hell are you doing here?
And if you fail, there's no place you can run.
Homestyle chicken noodle soup with an authentic homestyle taste because it's made like you'd make it yourself with tender pieces of chicken garnished with carrots, celery, and parsley and lots of little enriched noodles, all subtly seasoned in a rich broth. And if beef smoyer style, Campbell has a new homestyle beef noodle soup. Homestyle soups, down home, delicious and different.
Campbell's soup is good food.
Martini and Rossi invites you this holiday season to celebrate life.
Life is what you make it, so why not make it great? Look at life around you, come and celebrate.
Celebrate life, Martini and Rossi Asti Spumante, celebrate life.
Imported Martini and Rossi Asti Spumante, sparkling, bubbling, exciting, like life itself.
Martini and Rossi Asti Spumante, celebrate life.
Prohibition, eh?
It pays as good for guns as it is for booze.
Hey, get after that guy, come on!
Hello?
Danny, do you remember what I told you about Harry August? Now listen, I want you to call the number I gave you and give them the information.
But Papa, what's wrong? It's the middle of the night.
Danny, you must make that phone call.
Papa, why didn't you come here to tell me? Papa? Papa! Papa, answer me! Papa? Papa, answer me! Papa?
Now, the secret is to add the wine at the very end so that all the flavors are absorbed by the pasta. Are you following this?
Mm, well, it looks wonderful.
Well, it is wonderful.
Mm. I like your choice of music, too.
You see, I knew that about you. The second I saw you on the beach there in that swimsuit, I said to myself, now, Gav, there's a girl who likes pasta and classical music.
Is your intuition always right?
Well, no, not always, but I have a feeling tonight, though, it's... I think it's right on the money tonight.
Hello, Gavilan. We'd like to talk to you.
You know, it's guys like you who are going to ruin my open-door policy.
Forgive us for intruding.
We didn't mean to interrupt you and your friend.
Oh, we're not friends. Not yet.
We won't keep you long.
Robert, who are these people?
Spies.
I thought spies wore trench coats.
Well, they do, but only in Europe. Here they wear these awful baggy suits. I think they get them at the FBI rummage sale. They come with two pair of pants, don't they?
We get down to business.
Sure.
Robert, if you would rather be alone.
I would rather be alone with you, though. Now, Sam, just one second. Guys, why don't you do me a favor and come back tomorrow morning? Hey, better yet, don't come back at all.
We wouldn't be here if it weren't important.
Oh, heck, I'm sure it's important. Look, guys, give me a break.
maybe it's best if I do leave.
No, it's not best. It's not best at all. We can go out for a lobster.
Maybe another time.
We have a request.
You have a request, huh? Seeing how you've done so much for me, I'm probably sure I can't refuse. You mind?
2912 call came from Paris today.
That's impossible. Let me see that. Well, there's got to be some kind of mistake.
Oh, no, Gavilan, no mistake.
2900 code is yours. It's still in the computer.
So is my resignation from the spy business. It's been in there for 7 years.
Then why are we getting a priority red call for you?
I don't know. Check your computer. You're not going to eat that. Put it in the sink.
We thought you'd like to fly over and find out why.
Sure, why not? You ruin my dates, you ruin my pasta, I got nothing better to do.
There's a plane ticket. Expense money. You may just want to satisfy your curiosity.
If you don't go,
I'll return the unused portion.
You missed a mushroom over there.
Long time.
Yes, you were a little girl. You changed.
You haven't?
Not true. Well, what are you doing here?
I'm waiting for you.
I was supposed to meet your father.
No. I sent that message at his request. He has disappeared. I'm frightened for him.
Have you called the police?
Of course. They shrugged and smiled and said it was the risk of the business he was in.
Why was he calling me?
He stumbled onto some information. An American racketeer named Harry August. He lives in England. Papa says he's a very dangerous man.
Never heard of him.
Papa discovered that he was engineering the theft of a huge shipment of NATO arms.
And your father was going to sell that information to the authorities.
He tried to give it to them. He didn't want the money, just to regain his credibility. 2 years ago, he was given some false information. He was some, what is your expression, set up. And after that, no one trusted him. Not the Americans, not the British.
Only you.
And you. He felt that you would still believe him.
Danny, I don't know what I can do. I wouldn't even know where to begin to look for your
father.
What
was important to Papa was his good name. He wanted you to prove for him what he could not possibly have done.
Honey, I'm not in that business anymore.
And your friendship with my father, was that only business?
You know better than that.
I know what he told me, that you are a man of honor. Now you say you have changed. Is the loss of honor one of these changes?
I guess I've grown a little more pragmatic. That happens as you get older.
So my father's request is a victim of pragmatism. I'm glad he's not here to see it.
Ginger Schneider, a super prize winner.
I won $250,000 from Publishers Clearinghouse. Suddenly, I could buy a house, invest, send my son on a trip he'd been dying to take.
The new Publishers Clearinghouse Triple Sweepstakes is in the mail right now with over $1 million in prizes. Win cash, cars, yachts, trips, homes, even a $250,000 super prize. Enter the new Publishers Clearinghouse Sweepstakes now. It's our biggest ever. We want to make you a winner.
From Atari, made especially for systems from Atari, the video game that lets you help E.T. get home just in time for Christmas. Happy holidays.
Wanna have some fun? Try to guess which of these toys will run longer. Here's a clue. It's the one with the Duracell battery. That's because when you leave it running, a Duracell battery will last up to 6 times longer. So it will still be going long after regular carbon batteries have stopped working. If you guess the pink elephant, you're right. Duracell. The copper top battery. It makes all your toys last longer.
Wednesday, it's the wildest real people of the year as you meet Sarah's biggest fan and visit the world's smallest country. Then Natalie takes charm lessons from Blair.
And I just had another one of my brilliant ideas.
The facts of life. And it's a special night for Alex.
It's your first time, wasn't it?
Sort of.
Family ties. Then.
What does it take to make a murderer out of a 14-year-old?
A youth gang is on a murder spree, and Quincy's out to stop them.
Wednesday is going to be great on NBC.
Friday, a gang comes looking for the Knight Rider.
I believe there is a considerable risk factor involved in this operation.
But after Kit catches up with the bikers, their leader catches up with Michael.
Expecting someone.
The concierge. Every morning he brings me fresh croissants.
Do you want him to die?
No. No, no, please, no, no.
Then get rid of him.
Don't hurt him. He's a harmless old man. He's hard of hearing. Merci, Monsieur Gonon. I don't want any croissants today.
I get back over there.
I think that's going to have to wait.
I don't understand.
Let me see if I can explain it for you. Your father was following a man by the name of Harry August. Your father disappears. You send me a message and someone shows up and tries to kill you. Are you starting to get the picture?
But you said there was nothing you could do.
Well, I can't always be right.
So what do we do?
Well, we go to London and we look for a man named Harry August.
What happened to the pragmatism that comes with age?
Not as old as I thought.
Victor, find out anything in Paris?
The man at the warehouse was named Rudy Aldo.
What is that supposed to mean? Something to me?
He was a penny-ante informer, selling to anyone who would buy. Fortunately, he lacked credibility in the marketplace.
Oh, so he's not to worry about.
Perhaps a little. He made one phone call from a public booth.
And Victor checked with the phone company, right?
Hmm. He found out where the call went to. He said he'll handle it in the usual manner. Harry, what is the usual manner?
Hey. Better you shouldn't know, huh?
A new Indian blend. Isn't that interesting? Would you care to try it?
Oh, thanks, Giles. You got a beer?
Oh, Gavilan. I would have thought that over the years you might have acquired some sense of gracious living. Miss Orlow.
Yes, thank you. Mr. Winston, why does British intelligence have an office like this?
Ah, you mean the undercover aspect? Well, there are a number of people we do business with who prefer their comings and goings to be clandestine.
Who fear for their safety.
Yes, little men clutching table scraps of information, anxious to squeeze every penny they can out of us. I regret to say that your father was one of them.
But you never hesitated to use him or his information.
True enough. As long as we could substantiate it.
Did he talk to you about Harry August?
Oh, yes, indeed. It became his passion. His Sistine Chapel. The fresco of a beleaguered imagination.
You did check it out?
Of course. Harry August came here a wealthy man.
Now, Giles, how do you suppose he got all that money?
According to our sources, not from arms dealing. He bought Bensington Hall Manor, paid cash for it. In the present economic climate, it's a very good transplant.
And what about the hijacked NATO shipment?
Alleged hijacking.
Come on, Giles. I heard about it in Malibu on the 11 o'clock news.
Well, we're still carrying it as classified.
You guys care the American Revolution is classified.
Gavilan, you are no longer in the employ of your government. Do not involve yourself with things that don't concern you. Miss Orlow, it's nice meeting you. And if you forgive me, I have a report to prepare.
Rudy Orlow is right. Your next report is going to be for the unemployment office. I'm sure they'll find something interesting for you to do for a man of your passion and your vision, like stuffing tea bags. Guess they all wear those funny suits.
Fellow.
Oh, Giles was always one of my favorite people.
Robert, I appreciate very much what you're doing.
I haven't done anything yet. So I'll do my best.
Follow me now, girls. And here we are at the notorious underground, and we're going down to Wicked Whitechapel, where Jack the Ripper, no less.
The hotel's just right down on the end of the block there. Could I meet you there in a couple of hours?
Goodbye.
Dear ladies, in Crocodile. Definitely. But you'll find it perfectly safe at this time of year.
Milo!
Robert! Excuse me, ladies.
What a coincidence.
Yeah.
Ladies, would you excuse us for a moment? Can I have a word with you?
Sure.
I'd expected you to be in the moors by now.
Ah, yes, the moors. Well, it's a little boggy, you know, since the recent rains. Besides, the logistics made the tour unprofitable.
I know this is going to sound like it's off the wall, but what can you tell me about Bensington Hall?
You must be joking.
I'm not joking.
Well, you said Balmoral or Blenheim Palace.
But
so
I'm not. I said Bensington Hall. Hall.
Yes. Well, I used to take lessons in ballroom dancing there.
Really?
Terrible people. Mm. It's a beautiful place.
Yeah. What can you tell me about the layout of the place?
Well, my dancing partner and I used to sneak out into the grounds now and then. Interesting places to hide.
Mm. Okay, I need your help. You're going to have to get rid of the ladies for a while.
Yeah, that would be most discourteous. What am I going to tell them?
I don't know. Tell them you're going to the moors to check for moisture. You'll think of something.
Yeah.
Mr. Was it Callinger? I'm glad we were able to conclude our transaction without a lot of pain. So, before we go, you know, like chasing after the fox, I'd like to propose a toast.
To our mutual clients. We look forward to the delivering of your wares.
Oh, I'll drink to that. Yeah.
Excuse me, sir. You wanted to inspect the saddle we'll be placing on your mount.
Oh, yeah. I want to make sure there's no lumps. Well, in the top. In the bottom, I don't care. That's the horse's problem, right?
Yeah, it's fine.
So, cheers, huh?
Yes.
Hello. I'm from the West Sussex Statuary and Monument Works Limited. Is Mr. August here?
Sorry, but
well,
I know...
Well, Mr. August has ordered several of our statues, and we're just about ready to deliver. But there seems to be a little bit of a problem. Would you mind stepping out, please? Thank you so much. You see, he ordered, Mr. August did, he ordered one of our 7-foot King Richard III, and also one of our 5-foot Henry VIII. Would you mind stepping this way?
I'm sorry, I know nothing about this.
If you don't mind. Thank you so much. Now, I'll tell you my problem. You see, we have lost one of the invoices, so we don't know whether Mr. August would like his Richard or his Henry out here. what do you think?
I have no idea.
Actually, how foolish of me. It wasn't either his Richard or his Henry. It was our 8-foot Victoria and Albert, the Queen and our beloved consort. Yes, we're doing a special on the royal couple, you know. Thank you for listening.
Tell, are you?
Well, Harry said I should make myself at home.
I don't think this is exactly what he had in mind.
What are you going to do? Oh, don't touch that button.
Why shouldn't I?
Because if you do, I'm sure that some men are going to come through that door and they're going to do their best to put holes in my brand new sweater. Do you like this sweater? And you and I would have no chance to get to know each other better. That'd be a tragic loss.
And what would I be missing?
Well, you'd be missing my wit, my charm, my bon vivant style. Just don't touch that button.
Then please explain what you're doing here.
I'm a common thief.
Albeit a very charming one.
Thank you.
But my mother told me to always be wary of thieves in the house, even a charming one.
Wise woman, your mother.
Wait, what the hell
is that guy doing? Hey, hey, hey!
Thanks very much, old boy.
Get after him!
Be nice. I'm new at this. I hope you know what you're doing.
Horses were so sensitive. Oh. Now I know how the fox feels.
Every day, people face the moment of truth. The moment they decide if their dishwasher detergent did the job.
If I have to rewash the glasses.
Or didn't quite do the job.
Spots. I have to rewash the glasses.
Try Cascade. Most detergents can leave drops that spot, but Cascade sheeting action leaves glasses virtually spotless. Cascade's moment of truth.
Look at that shine. Now that's beautiful.
Is Cascade's moment of glory.
Do many American students get diarrhea down here?
Sure, sooner or later. But you know what, Mom? A lot of us participated in a test that American doctors ran.
A diarrhea test?
A scientific clinical test, a real thing. Whole lot of students with diarrhea. The doctors gave our group Pepto-Bismol.
Good old Pepto-Bismol.
And did it work? Most of us got relief in 24 hours, including me.
That's wonderful. So it really does work.
He passes one test in 2 years. It's a diarrhea test.
Kick off your New Year's Day with the biggest bowl bonanza ever. First up, the Fiesta Bowl. Then the granddaddy of them all, the Rose Bowl. Followed by the Orange Bowl. All this without ever changing your dial on NBC Sports. New Year's Day.
Now, top money market rates. With insured safety, plus full liquidity, the money market deposit account. New at Northern Trust Bank.
Gloria Vanderbilt black denim jeans have all the mystery and magic of black. It's a shame to call them jeans.
Dominic's Produce Specialist presents savings on tomatoes. Red ripe tomatoes are delicious in salads. Medium-sized tomatoes are just 38 cents a pound through Sunday at Dominic's.
A big hike in some natural gas bills, a story at 10.
That was a rather hasty exit.
I hope you said my goodbyes for me.
I would have, but there was no one to extend them to.
Please, drive.
I must say, you're quite a jumper.
Jumping is the easy part. Landing is the hard part.
Oh, dear. Look, sit in a steaming hot bath with powdered mustard for 10 minutes. It irons out all the kinks, all the worries there. I know, because my dad was a racehorse trainer.
I thought you said your dad was in the Navy.
No, I was in the Navy. Captain Bentley, he was in the cavalry. Where, now, where do you want to go?
I'd like to go take that bath, but I think I'll go see Giles Winston instead. Maybe after all this, he'll believe me.
It's not bad weather for the time of year.
I could have sworn you said your father was in the Navy.
No, cavalry, horses, horses.
You know what the cavalry is? We have cavalries in America.
Oh, do you really?
Have you heard of Teddy Roosevelt?
Teddy Roosevelt, yes, charge.
Now, watch the potholes, please.
Right, whoops.
All right, Mr. August, what was that all about?
Hey, did you guys ever have your place busted into?
No, we have security. What do you think, my guys with the guns are butlers? What are you getting so uptight about anyway?
What was he after?
I got a lot of valuable stuff around here.
We're afraid it wasn't your valuables he was after.
Now, wait. Wait, what are you saying, he was after the guns? Huh? No chance! And nobody is going to figure I'm into dealing.
Maybe not. But we're talking about a great deal of weapons here.
And a large amount of money. Your security doesn't give us any reassurance. And look, you got my guarantee. That's your reassurance.
If you'll forgive me, that doesn't mean anything to us.
All right, now look. You can take my word to the bank. You ask anybody in the States.
We're not in the States.
All right, it's this simple. I got what you need. Now, you don't want to do business. I got plenty of other guys waiting in line. And you could take your lousy little emerging countries and arm them with slingshots. I couldn't care less. Now, do you want a deal or not? Because if you don't, get the hell out.
We do.
Oh, yeah.
But be warned. We count on your delivery. As do our clients. And if you fail, there's no place you can run. Tomorrow night for the transaction.
Yeah. But hey, listen up. Show up with the cash, huh? I don't take credit cards.
Why didn't you tell me?
No, honey, after that phone call, I was afraid to contact you. I didn't want to put you in any danger.
She was already in danger.
Unfortunately, yes. But when I saw you'd arrived, I knew she'd be safe.
I'm glad you have such confidence in my invulnerability.
Should have seen you on a horse.
Did you get anything out of the August place?
Well, aside from a sore backside, I got a couple of names.
Like who?
Callisher, Martin, a few others.
Oh, yes, the people he deals with. They contact the actual buyers. The two of them act as middlemen.
There's no way of bringing the authorities in.
No, Callisher is a licensed arms dealer. As long as they don't know where he got the arms, nothing can be done.
What were you planning on doing with this?
When I saw you go into Harry August's place, I figured if anything happened to you, I was going to blow it up. And him along with it.
Rudy, that's hardly the point. It's the weapons we're after.
Was there any indication of where they were?
None that I could find.
Any other names?
No. Well, there was one other name. I found it on an envelope in the safe. Felix Stowe. Do you know him?
No, I never heard of him.
Felix Stowe, yes. It's a seaport on the East Coast. I was stationed there for a while during the war.
Well, they moved you around a lot, didn't they?
Well, it's harder to hit a moving target. There's an artillery emplacement there. The big guns are gone, but the bunkers still exist. It's a little like a rabbit warren.
Perfect place to hide weapons. Oh. I think we might find a use for this plastic explosive after all.
And now, a sizzling message from Burger King.
In this commercial, Burger King promises not to say anything to make you hungry. Not a single delicious word. We just had to tell you one simple thing. In a coast-to-coast survey, nearly 2 out of 3 people chose broiling over frying. Burger King broils, McDonald's and Wendy's fry. That's it, the whole commercial. And not once did we say,
aren't you hungry for Burger King now?
When an alkaline battery goes dead, you throw it away and buy a new one. This is a GE rechargeable. When it goes dead, you recharge it. It costs more than batteries you throw away, but lasts up to 4 years. Used 10 hours a week, this toy would use over 300 long-life batteries to just 2 GE rechargeables. So if you're still throwing away batteries, you're throwing away a lot of money.
In 1983, Intellivision owners won't believe their luck, because while others are asking you to buy a completely new system, Mattel Electronics is revolutionizing Intellivision, making gameplay like this possible simply by adding a computer keyboard.
And now, during this holiday season, Intellivision buyers won't believe their luck, because if you buy an Intellivision Master component before December 31st, 1982, Mattel Electronics will send you a $50 rebate. Happy holidays with a $50 rebate from the makers of Intellivision.
Thursday, put on your shoes and get rid of those blues. Go high-stepping through the streets of New York on Fame. Then when Sam and Diane fall in love, there's just one problem. Nobody told Diane. Cheers. And why is Alex chasing Louie?
He's got a date with my ex-wife.
On Taxi. Then the second episode of a special 4-part series.
I want this golf ball booked, locked up, or I quit.
Hill Street Blues.
Thursday on NBC. Now, that's a Cracker Jack lineup.
Up there.
Well, I guess I go it alone from here.
Right.
You know, you could protest just a little.
True, true. But if things go wrong, I can always sing the praises of your...
My heroism.
Right.
It makes me feel a lot better.
Well, this time I don't have to worry about falling off a horse.
Thank you.
Hey, you awake, McGregor? Good evening, Mr. August. It's a pleasure to see you again. Miss Hyde Smith.
Yeah, everything's set.
Yes, sir. Here is the complete tabulation.
Yeah, and the trucks, they're on their way?
Should be here in about an hour. This order's just going to about clean us out.
Yeah, well, that's what we like. Moving the inventory, huh? Come on.
Check the arms again.
Look, I just want to make sure nobody's taken any free samples.
You know, Harry, you missed your calling. You should have been an accountant.
Oh, yeah. And you should have learned how to keep your mouth shut. What the hell are you doing here?
Window shopping. But I haven't found a thing I like.
You certainly do get around, don't you?
Well, I like to see all the sights. It's a nice coat. Lynx, isn't it? That's on the endangered species list.
Yeah, so are you. Now, who are you?
Well, that might take a little time to explain.
Oh, well, don't sweat it. I got all the time in the world.
Not necessarily. I'd say about 3 minutes and counting.
What are you talking about?
Well, I set a bomb to go off in here.
Oh, yeah.
Well, actually, I set three bombs. There's one right over there.
What? What, you brought bombs in here? What, are you crazy?
Ah! I suggest you get the hell out of here.
That, Harry?
She just did.
Look. Look, see, I can get it started again, and you can be in on it. I just need a little time.
Oh, you're gonna have plenty of time. Plenty of time. I think your clients are gonna want to know what happened here tonight. I'm gonna let you explain it, Harry. You have a nice night.
It's here, the Better tolerated aspirin. New improved Bayer aspirin with the patented micro-thin coating. It's better tolerated than regular aspirin. Here's why. Regular aspirin can be chalky, hard to swallow, but coated Bayer goes right down with no bitter taste in the throat, no burning, and Bayer is as fast and effective as ever. It's here. Improved Bayer with the patented micro-thin coating. New improved Bayer. There's never been an aspirin like it, ever.
JCPenney announces a come see what you can't see sale. 25% off every bra and girdle in the store. Come see our very feminine underwire bras, our seamless stretch bras and crossover bras. You can save on all our bras, from plain to fancy, and on all our girdles, including a smooth little panty brief. What you can't see here, you'll see at JCPenney for 25% off. See you there.
Friday, it's the Orange Bowl Parade from Miami with host Joe Garagiola and Shelley Long from Cheers. It's a sizzling goodbye to 82. Next, a gang comes looking for the Knight Rider.
I believe there is a considerable risk factor involved in this operation.
But after Kit catches up with the bikers, their leader catches up with Michael. Then, the disasters, the disappearances, the dead, the undead, the unexplained, the unbelievable, the secrets of the Bermuda Triangle.
Friday is going to be great on NBC.
Yes, Cheryl, I'm sorry about the spaghetti dinner, too. No, I'm not angry. I would have walked out, too, I suppose. I just don't feel like a party, that's all. I'm really exhausted. I had a long trip, and I'm going to spend the day right here on the sofa. Yeah, well, we'll do it another time. If I change my mind, yeah, but I don't think so. Maybe some other time. Okay. Bye-bye.
Beautiful day on the beach, Robert.
Yes. Yeah, I can see from here.
I'd be happy to take a blanket down there for you.
Oh, no thanks. I'm very comfortable right where I am.
You know, you could do with a little sun. All that time in London. You look pale.
Milo, why do I get the feeling you're trying to get me out of the house?
Oh, not for one minute, my dear boy. No, it's just that I thought you ought to take advantage of this marvelous weather.
I'm going to. Right here.
I'll get it.
What an adorable house, Mr. Bentley. Did it really belong to Alice Faye?
We can't wait to see the war curios you were telling us about.
The beach.
I love your hat.
This is Linda Yu. At 10 o'clock tonight, customers of People's Gas and North Shore Gas will see their rates go up soon. We'll tell you when and by how much. Also, the number one auto insurer is raising its rates. James Lewis, charged in the Tylenol extortion case, was in a Chicago court. We'll have details on what happened. That and more on Channel 5 News at 10.
It's part talk show, part game show, and totally outrageous. It's Just Men, the show where celebrity heartthrobs let it all hang out, premiering Monday.